Welcome back to Ant Lives the channel. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Hit that notification bell if you are new to the channel. Trust me, you do not want to miss out on my daily builds. And as I always say, I got your back. The channel gang, new subscribers, you're going to find out, new subscribers, that I got your back. And as I always say, the channel gang, you know I got your back. This right here is my 182nd video for NBA 2K22 current gen. And it is a lob threat that will have a mid-range shot, a three-point shot, course of free throw, and a fadeaway. This is a bad boy right here. Now, we're going to go right here to down to this pie chart right here. And this is the 3/4 finishing and the 2/3 defensive pie chart. Okay, now you already know we got the 10. We're going to go right here because we're going to get speed and strength out of this build. All right, now we're going to go all the way up on his close shot. We're going to go all the way up on his driving dunk. Then we're going to go all the way up on his standing dunk. Then we're going to come all the way up on his mid-range. Then we're going to go all the way up on his three-pointer. And we're just going to bring his free throw to 70. Now we're going to go all the way up on his fadeaway shot. Then we're going to bring his pass accuracy to 53. Then we're going to go all the way up on his ball handle. And we're going to go all the way up on his post control. Now, I did find out that you do get a 10 to your ball handle when you ignite the slash and takeover. So those guys that I said may have been deceiving, my greatest apologies to you guys for being right and exact about that. Now, we're going to come up on his offensive rebound. And this build is going to have a total badge count. Let's see. 30, because that's 24 and 6 shooting, 40 with the 10 playmaking, 58 total badges on this build. This is a bad dude. Now, we're going to come right here to built, right? Now, we're going to drop him to 6'7", and then we're going to drop his weight to 195, okay? We're going to go to 195 on this build. And then we're going to kick his wingspan all the way back to 79.0. So, at 99 overall, you're going to have a close shot of 90. When you unite the size to take over, you know that's going to be 100. Then you're going to have a driving dunk of 95. And when you unite the size to take over at 99 overall, that's going to be 105 because it goes over the cap at 99. And then you're going to have a standing dunk of 81. So when you unite the size to take over, that will be a 91. This build is going to come with all the elite contact dunk packages and alley-oop packages. Now, you're going to have a mid-range of 71. When you unite the size to take over, because you get a 5 to that as well, you're going to, that is going to be a 76. Then you're going to have a three-pointer of 61, and when you unite the size takeover, that's going to be a 66. Then you're going to have a free throw and a post fade at 76 and 99 overall. And when you unite the size takeover, both of them will be a 81. Now, if you don't know how to use the shoot the free fadeaway jump shot, go to my fadeaway tutorial. It's called Fadeaway Tutorial. Learn how to shoot fadeaways like Michael Jordan and Kobe Bryant. You'll love that video because I show you so many different angles and so many different ways how to use it off the dribble. Now, your pass accuracy and your playmaking gets a 5 as well, and then your ball handling does get a 10. So at 99 overall, you're going to have a pass accuracy of 61, and when your knight decides to take over, that will be a 66. Then you're going to have a ball handle of 77, so you're going to be able to get some point guards signature combination dribble moves out of this build, and it's going to be nasty. It's going to be a great ball handler for you. So when your knight decides to take over at 99 overall, then that's when you're going to be able to speed boost, because that's going to be an 87. This build is lights out. Now you're going to have a post control of 74 at 99 overall, and when your knight decides to take over, that's going to be a 79. Then you're going to have, because you get 5 of your defensive rebound as well when your knight decides to take over. So it's 99 overall, you're going to have an interior defense of 67, and when your knight decides to take over, that's going to be a 72. You're going to have a lot of quickness of 86, and when your knight decides to take over, that will be a 91. Then you're going to have a block of 69 and 99 overall, and when your knight decides to take over, that's going to be a 74. Then you're going to have an defensive rebound. Well, you're going to have an offensive rebound of 54, and when your knight decides to take over 99 overall, that's going to be a 59. And then you're going to have a defensive rebound of 76, and when your knight decides to take over, that will be an 81. Now, the juicy part is the physicals on this build, where it's going to be lights out. As you see, is very strong. You're going to be very strong, and you're going to be able to drive to the hole with consistency once you get it up. Once you get to a black, you're going to notice a dramatic change in the build once you get that silver quick first step, okay? But now we all know there's three ways you get it. One is the Gatorade facility. Two is level 40. And then the third way is winning the NBA championship, which is the fastest way. And then the other way we all know as well is getting to 99 overall, and you get your other 4. So at 99 overall, You're going to have a speed of 92, an acceleration of 90, a vertical of 74, and a strength of 82. When Unite decides to take over, your speed will go over the cap of 99, and that will be 102. Your acceleration will go over the cap of 99 as well, because that's going to be 100. Then you're going to have a strength of 92. Well, you're going to have a strength of 92 because you're going to have a strength of 82 and 99 overall. So when Unite decides to take over, that's going to be a 92. That is crazy. Now, you're... vertical will be a 74, but when Unite decides to take over, that's going to turn into an 84. This is a bad boy right here. Now, of course, we got the slash to take over. And there you have it. Only an Antlizer channel. Now, do we have a lob threat that is a legit threat from the perimeter? Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Hit that notification bell if you are new to the channel. And as I always say, I got your back. The channel game, you already know what time it is. I got your back. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to come here and I'm going to test the build. And what I mean by that, I'm just going to place the badges on the build and show you where I would place the badges if I was to use this build. This is a bad boy because of his strength. And it's going to be very hard to stop him. You know how you get those kind of impediments when you're going up for the alley-oop? It's going to be hard to stop him when even with that. We're going to go unstrippable. We're going to go limitless takeoff. We're going to go fast twitch. We're going to go rise up. And then we're going to go lob city finisher because that's what he is. And then we're going to go, matter of fact, he doesn't have a layup. He does have that. So we're going to go with grace under pressure right there. This boy is bad. Posterizer doesn't show up. It may show up if he used strength. I don't know yet. I'll let you guys know as I'm building up my build. Now, okay. Now, I'm going to show you real player shot percentage. And this is what I'm going to do. Catch and shoot. As a matter of fact, I'm going to go like this, catch and shoot, hot zone hunter, and then fade ace. And you can go with lucky seven somewhere if you want to. Now, you can go here, right, just to get that. Make sure when you catch that fast break ball, when you're under within 7 seconds under the shot clock from 24 to 17, this will drop. This will show up for you, okay, if that's where you want to go with it. Now, we got 10 playmaking, of course, unpluckable. Of course, he has a dribble, so we're going to go with quick hands. Then we're going to go with quick first step, gold. And then we're going to go with, let me make sure of this, hyperdrive for sure. All right, now we got 18, and that means we got 6 gold badges. Chase down because he has a block. Intimidator, rim protector, rebound chaser. We're going with clamps, and then the fact that you play in a low post, post lockdown, and that's going to shut a lot of people down because he's strong. And there you have it. Only an Antlizer channel. Now do you have this type of lob threat that can shoot? Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Hit that notification bell if you are new to the channel. And as I always say, I got your back. The channel gang, this is my 182nd video. We lit up in here. Thank you guys for all the support. And you know I got your back. And without anything further being said, I am out. Welcome back to Antlizer the channel. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Hit that notification bell if you are new to the channel. And as I always say, I got your back. The channel gang, you already know I got your back. This right here is my 182nd video for NBA 2K22 current gen. And also, this is a lob threat that can shoot the three ball, will have a mid-range, will be able to hit free throws, and have a fadeaway jump shot. Now, we're going to get into this build. We're going to come down here to this pie chart right here. Where is it? The new one. The 3/4 finishing and the 2/3 defensive pie chart. Okay. Now, what we're going to do, we're going to come right here to the third one because we want him to be strong. All right. And he's going to be fast, of course. Now, we want to go all the way up on his close shot, all the way up on his driving dunk, and then all the way up on his standing dunk. And that's going to give him 24 finishing badges. Now, we're going to bring his mid-range to 62. We're going to bring his three-pointer all the way up. Then we're going to just bring his free throw to 70. Now, we're going to bring his post-fade all the way up as well to 71. Now, we're going to bring His passing to 53 and his ball handle all the way up. And his post control all the way up as well. And that's going to give him 10 playmaking.